Okay, now let us start the chapter which I am going to start or which we both are going to study is reproduction. Why do organisms reproduce? Every year the weightage of this question, this chapter is 8 to 10 marks. Means it's not sure that every time the question will be of 10 marks or every time it will be of 2 marks. It can vary between 8 to 10. For example, few questions will be short answer type, means suppose two answers are coming, short answers. So it will carry 4 marks. One long answer question will be of 5 marks. So the weightage, normal weightage of this chapter that comes in board exam is varying between 8 to 10 marks. Two questions can be short as well as sometimes one short answer is coming in the exam and one is long question. Long question is sure and one short is also sure. Okay. So you, by revision of this chapter, you will be able to guess and you will be able to know that what type of questions are going to come in the exam and how you have to write, how you have to present and what are the things that are important from the board point of view. Okay. So let us start this. First of all, we will start with reproduction. That what is reproduction? Simply, reproduction is the process in which one organism will produce an another organism that will be of the same kind. Means not ditto exact, not it will be of same kind. There can be some variation also. That is the important significance of sexual reproduction. If there is no genetic variation and the things are morphological as well as genetic same, then it will be of asexual reproduction. So simply, if we want to define what is reproduction, so reproduction is a process where an organism produces others of same kind or same type. Suppose these are the parent, these parents will do the process of reproduction and there will be offspring. See, now what are the types of reproduction? These both types are simply opposite to each other and their characteristics will be also opposite. So first is asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is that type of reproduction in which there is no involvement of two parents. Okay, so only single parent is involved. Everybody listen carefully and see the things which I am writing on the board, because this question always come one after another here, that what are the differences between asexual and sexual. So you can write these answers in point. Only single parent is involved, first point in asexual. Okay. See, first point we were discussing about asexual reproduction, that only single parent is involved. The second point is that no gametes are formed. There is no formation of gametes. Okay. Third is that the cell division will take place by the process is known as mitotic division. Okay. And the fourth is that it is rapid. Means it does not take as much time as sexual reproduction takes. So these are the four points for the asexual. Simply we can summarize the sexual reproduction also. If you know asexual, easily you can describe about sexual reproduction. First point will be just opposite. Two parents are involved. As you can see in the above diagram also, the diagram is for sexual reproduction. Two, one is male and one is female. Second, formation of gamete takes place. So you can write gametes are formed. One is male gamete and another is female gamete. Third is the division that takes place in the cell is known as meiosis. Shitrit, what is your question? Hello. Okay. Now fourth is the process is slow. It's not as much as rapid as asexual reproduction. Yes, I will tell you about variation also in the next slide. Don't get panic. Each and everything we will discuss in this whole class, and at the last, those students who have problem or something, we will discuss on that also. Then don't worry, okay? See, next, what is the need of reproduction? So everybody know that the need of reproduction is just because there should be no extinction on this planet for the continuation of the species. Otherwise, like dinosaurs, we will also get extincted. Okay. So the basic event that takes place in reproduction is the creation of DNA copy. Now here one of the most important term come. This comes in board most of the time. Creation of DNA copy. Everybody know the structure of DNA? It is double helical, given by the scientists Watson and Crick. See what happened, the basic event in reproduction is creation of DNA. It means in reproduction when there is division of so many cells, for example there are so many cells formed, so there will be replication of the DNA also. Replication means multiplication. You can understand, I can help you to understand by this also. These are all the previous slides. See, in reproduction, this is your parent cell. Suppose male and female, and they are giving two offsprings. Suppose so many cells are formed after reproduction. So what will happen? There will be one DNA. DNA, not one, that is in pair. So this DNA will get multiplied. Multiplication of DNA is, in biology, it is known as replication. So after replication, they will, one will become two, two will become four, four will become eight. Okay, so this, each of the replicated DNA, they should be incorporated in each of the cell. Whatever are the DNA that are doing replication, they will be incorporated in each and every cell, so that each and every cell has the tendency to do the reproduction. Understood? So this phenomena is known as creation of DNA copy. Now somebody was asking about variation. Variation means differences. For example, in human beings, male is having certain features, female is having certain features, their characteristics or features are enclosed inside the DNA. When there is reproduction process, there will be overlap of the chromosomes and there will be transfer of few characters from the male and few characters from the female to the offsprings. So that will create variation, means the kids will be little bit different from the parents. Not all the characters will get transferred. But in asexual, there is no genetically and morphologically dissimilarity, all that will be similar. But in case of sexual, there are genetic variation and the variation is very necessary also. Why the variation is necessary? Because if there will be no variation, so there, if everybody will be same, then if any natural calamities like earthquake, disaster, or you can say flood, if anything is going on in the earth, so please mute your mic. So in that case, what will happen? Everybody have the same morphology, they have the same genetic combination, so everybody will be suffered at the same extent. We can understand this by the help of this bacteria. See, there was a population of bacteria in temperate water. Temperate water is neither too hot nor too cold. But due to global warming, most of the bacteria died because they were unable to resist the hot temperature. But at the same time, there were few more bacteria. Those have the capacity to resist this heat. Means they were able to survive. They are known as thermophilic. So they were able to survive in that drastic condition, that unfavorable condition, and just because of this characteristic of their survival made them to be alive on this earth. And those who were weak and those who can't survive, they all died. So variation is very necessary so as you can deal with the drastic condition. Understood? Now moving towards next. What are the different modes of reproduction? These are a kind of asexual reproduction. See, this first is fission, that is of amoeba. This is also important. It comes in board one after another year. After 1 year, it will be once again repeated that what is the mode of reproduction. So, binary fission and multiple fission. First of all, understand what is the meaning of fission. See, if there is one complex molecule and if this complex molecules get broken down into many smaller molecules, 1, 2, 3, 4, suppose I am making 4 smaller molecules. So this is known as fission. Oppositively, if there are so many small molecules and then they combine to form a larger molecule, then this is known as fusion. You have already studied these things in physics. So simply the meaning of the word fusion is same. One organism that is parent that will be splitted into the two organism. If it is getting splitted into two organism, the fission will be binary, and if it gets converted into the formation, one is getting formed into four, then it will be multiple. Always remember, fission, that is the asexual mode of reproduction, takes place in bacteria, protozoa, that is amoeba, paramecium and euglena. Now in detail we will study that what happens in asexual reproduction. Okay, see, first of all you can see this diagram. This is parent amoeba. In there is one nucleus, but in the second step, if I say, see, this is first step, let me write, this is second step. Okay, see, in first step this first nucleus will be converted into, getting multiplied into two nucleus, means the nucleus is first of all getting divided. The division of nucleus is known as, everybody know this, these all are the same thing which you all are studying throughout the year, karyokinesis. You have studied this term. Karyo means nucleus, kinesis means division. Division of nucleus is known as karyokinesis. Okay, now nucleus has been divided. Now see, in the second step, what these both, I mean not both, now still here they are single only, they are trying to stretch, means the cytoplasm here is getting thinner from the middle. From the diagram you can see that they are trying to become independent, they are trying to pull their cytoplasm toward their cells. So from the middle a time will come that the cytoplasm will become divided, means it will get divide and there will be formation of two amoeba. So this step is known as, very good, it is written by Shreyas in the class, very nice, cytokinesis. If it come in both, so you have to write in this way only, that first step is karyokinesis, second is cytokinesis. You will define karyo and cyto and then you will make this diagram and you will give example, then you will get the 5 marks. Okay, any problem? Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. Yeah, these all things are in NCERT and these are according to the board pattern. Now next asexual reproduction is fragmentation. Fragmentation is very easy, as you can, everybody can define this by the word only, fragment means the body will divide into small pieces. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. Now each of the four pieces will known as fragment, and each of the fragments have the tendency to grow into new individuals. But one important point that you have to remember, that the fragmentation process always takes place in unicellular. Let me write here because it will be more visible. Then it always takes place in unicellular organism, those organism which has only one cell. The best example is Spirogyra. Now the question came that why doesn't it take place in multicellular? So the answer is this, that in multicellular there are so many cells and it's not possible for each and every cells of the tissue, in multicellular there are so many cells, so it's not possible for each and every cell to break themselves in fragments and then to reproduce. That will be impractical. So this question, this point you should remember, that fragmentation is not true for all multicellular organism. It always takes place in unicellular. Okay. Next, another method of asexual reproduction is regeneration. Regeneration, re means again, and generation means to produce. So organisms like Planaria as well as Hydra. Planaria is a group, is from the animal kingdom you studied in class 9. Let me revise you. Planaria, the body is bilateral symmetry. What it will do? It will reproduce itself by the asexual method, that is regeneration. In this, if planaria is cut into 2 to 3 pieces, each of the part will grow and they will become adult. And now they will perform their own reproduction process. Okay, and the process in which, see, the difference between the fragmentation and what is in regeneration, that fragment in regeneration, it can take place in multicellular, because planaria is multicellular, no? And but regeneration always takes place in unicellular. Okay, this important thing you have to discuss. And always don't, beta, please don't forget the example. Next, which we have to discuss is budding. Budding, by the name of budding, you all become happy because you all are studying this budding process in HIDEP since class 6 only. Budding is the process in which a small outgrowth, that is known as bud, will arise at the base of the parent body. This is a small bud, an outgrowth. How does it come? Because the cells at the base of the hydra will undergo rapid cell division. Due to rapid cell division, there will be eruption. Eruption means some swallow-like structure, some knob-like structure, which is known as bud, is developed at the base of the hydra. Now, what will happen? This will undergo, it will not stop its division. It will continuously, it comes under asexual reproduction. These all are asexual, which we are discussing. So, it will undergo continuous cell division, then it will form a little larger, you can say, the bud. Now, once again, it will do cell division, it will become more larger, and at last, it will become so large that now it wants to live its life independently. So, it will detach itself from the body of the parent. So, this process is known as budding. Okay, and this is one of the most important asexual mode of reproduction in Hydra, and this is also important. This also comes in exam, that name the method of asexual reproduction that takes place in Hydra. Next is vegetative propagation. Now, vegetative propagation takes place, the leaf which I mentioned here is bryophyllum. Bryophyllum is the leaf that is drawn or that is placed here. Vegetative part can be anything. It can be root, it can be stem, it can be leaves. Means those plants which do not produce seed, then how they will do reproduction? Majority what happened? That seeds will come and then fruit will come and then reproduction is also going on. But those plants which do not produce the seeds, like banana, they will do the reproduction by the process of vegetative propagation, by the help of their vegetative parts, means root, stem and leaves. As you can see in this diagram also, see, this is the leaf of bryophyllum. They are a small leafy structure. They are known as adventitious bird. Adventitious they are, it means they have the capacity, they have the tendency to generate themselves into a new plant. Okay? So what the question that comes in board, that is most important related to this topic, that what are the plants in which vegetative propagation takes place? So seedless plant like rose, those oranges which does not have seeds, banana and jasmine. Okay? Now, what is the advantage and disadvantage? First advantage is that it is very easy and cheaper method. You can understand by this statement only, there is nothing to explain in this. It is cheap, means it does not involve much finance or much money, so that is going to be better for the farmers. It is very easy, it does not need any instrumentation or technical terms or fertilizers or anything, means it's the basic method of reproduction. Second is that those who does not have seeds, they will do the reproduction. But the disadvantage is that, as you all know, that it is asexual mode of reproduction. It means there will be no variation. Means the parent and the offspring, they are genetically as well as morphologically same. Morphologically means in appearance, physically, and genetically means the number of genes and the constituent of genes, all both things will be similar, so there will be no variation. And if there is no variation, there is little chance of survival. Okay, understood? Next mode of reproduction, that is of asexual type, its spore formation. One of the common method of reproduction in rhizopus. Rhizopus is known as bread mold. It's a kind of fungus. As you are seeing this diagram, you know that this is hyphae, thread-like structure. You already studied these things. Always remember, those who are asking the question that it's mitosis or meiosis, I told you that in asexual reproduction, it's mitosis. Whether it is budding, whether it is spore formation, whether it is vegetative propagation, or it is binary fission. Okay, always remember and keep it in your mind. This part is known as mycelium. And at the top here is a circular knob-like structure that is known as sporangium. See, this sporangium, when it will burst out by the help of external agents like air, water, or by animals. Animals and one more is insect. So what will happen? Air, water, animal, insects, if by the help of these external agents, this sporangium is getting ruptured, or if the air is hitting the sporangium, it will get ruptured and small grains like structure will come out that are known as spores. And when these spores will fall on the land, there they will develop into the new individual. So this is the one of the best method for the rhizopus, that is a kind of bread mold. It always takes place in multicellular organism. Thread-like structure is observed. These all are thread-like structure that are known as hyphae. Okay. So these were the mycelium and hyphae are the part of the fungus. Mycelium is the collection here and hyphae is the thread-like structure. Okay. Always the question comes that what is the mode of reproduction in bread mold or rhizopus. If you have your notebook, you can write down also rhizopus is known as bread mold. That is the common name. Now we have done with asexual reproduction. Moving towards sexual reproduction. But before sexual reproduction, I want to tell you one more thing. When we are studying about budding, we studied about binary fission and multiple fission. Binary fission, so I told you. Multiple fission, let us also study that what it is, so that if it comes in exam, so it should not be that you don't know. See, multiple fission is one of that fission that always takes place in unfavorable conditions. Favorable condition is binary and unfavorable is multiple. In multiple fission, what will happen? Suppose this is amoeba. So amoeba will, I am taking the best example is bacteria. See, in multiple fission, if there is bacteria, so it will develop a protective layer that is known as cyst. And then all the nucleus here, it will go continuous division, division, division means what is happening? Karyokinesis, division of nucleus is taking place. As soon as the condition will become favorable, this cyst will break down and all of these nucleus will come outside, and around all of the nucleus there will be a small quantity of cytoplasm. If we consider the case of amoeba, as we are knowing that one amoeba was giving birth to two daughter amoeba, and when this one amoeba will give birth to two daughter amoeba, and this will also give birth to two daughter amoeba. See, if we consider from top, this is parent and this is daughter cells. So one parent is giving rise here to daughter amoeba, but in the last step, one parent is giving rise to four daughter amoeba. So that is known as multiple fission. Okay. So if it comes in exam, then you should know. Normally binary fission is coming in exam most of the time, but you should know about the multiple fission also. Now the next method of reproduction that we are going to start is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is considered better type of reproduction over the asexual reproduction. The reason is that there is variation. And where there is variation, there is more chances of survival. So So first of all, why the sexual mode? Variation is observed. There will be two type of gamete. You know the symbol male is written by this and female is
Adictus.
See, somebody is writing about mutation. First of all, everybody please mute your mic. Mutation is a kind of sudden change in the genetic expression. Mutation is not a normal process. Okay, mutation is a kind of disorder.
Fragment.
Okay, don't worry.
Okay, now this is the symbol of male and this is the symbol of female. There will be formation of male gamete in sexual reproduction and there will be formation of female gamete. The mean gametes. The male gamete will be motile because it has a small tail-like structure and the female gamete is non-motile and it is reservoir of the food and it will give nutrition. So when this male gamete will combine with female gamete, it will form zygote. This male gamete is haploid, means n, the number of chromosome. This female gamete, that is ova, it is also haploid, that is n. By the combination, everybody know the addition, it will become 2n and the 2n is known as diploid and the zygote nature is diploid. Okay, so what you have studied in sexual reproduction, variation is observed, there is formation of two types of gamete, male gamete and female gamete.
Troy,
who is disturbing the class? Everybody please keep your mic mute and just simply message, don't disturb the class. Second point is that there is formation of two type of gamete, male gamete and female gamete. Male gamete, female gamete. The process by which the gamete is getting formed is known as gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means formation of gamete. Now this both gamete will combine with each other and they will form zygote. This process is known as fertilization. In next slide, after 1 to 2 slides, we will discuss in detail also what is fertilization and what is double fertilization. Okay. Now the things which you have to remember that male gamete is known as sperm.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Say.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah. Say, I can listen your voice.
Yeah, ma'am. Shreyas S has a doubt in the chat box. Can you please clarify it for him? Thank you.
What is the message? Shreyas has a doubt. Wait. We will clear all the doubt in the last so that there will be no problem. But where is ma'am my doubt? Where is the doubt?
Mom is asking the little bit more up, ma'am. Yeah. No.
Variation will be less for the same reason. For which reason? Mutation one. See, if you are talking about mutation, so mutation is not a part of sexual and asexual reproduction, first of all. Mutation is a kind of disorder in which there is sudden change in the gene expression. Simply, if you are suffering from the cancer, in that case, oncogene is getting mutated. It is present in everybody's body. It is in the formation, it is in the inactive form. But if you will simply poke that gene and you will have some drinking and you are taking some carcinogenic substances, you are disturbing your lifestyle, in that case, there will be mutation in the oncogene and it will become active. So there is nothing, no relation between mutation and asexual reproduction, first of all. Okay? And we will discuss all these things, but in the last, but first of all, let us focus here. Next is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Flowering plant, by seeing this plant only, you can tell me the name. What is the name of the flower? Please everybody write in the chat box. I hope you know the answer. Hibiscus, very good. What is the other name of hibiscus? Common name? Somebody is writing flower. Obviously, every it is a flower only. Yeah, good. China rose. See, China rose or hibiscus, both are same. This is one of the best example to study about sexual reproduction because it is bisexual. Bisexual, I am using this term only in case of flower. The flower in which there is both sex organs, male as well as female. But if we talk about organism, those organisms which have male as well as female, then in that case we will use the term hermaphrodite. Okay, so now this is a flower having both male and female part, that is known as bisexual. So first of all here, first part that is known as A, you can see A part, this one is known as sepals or calyx. They are green in color. They contain chlorophyll. Their function is to perform photosynthesis. B part is colorful and is covering the internal parts. See, this B part that is known as petals or we can say corolla is colorful. They have basically two functions. First is that they are so much colorful that they will attract the insect for the process of pollination. We will discuss pollination also after this slide. And the second function of the petals is that they will cover the internal reproductive parts. Next is C. In order to get about C, first of all, we should know about E and F. See, this one structure is known as, this is known as anther, and it is connected to a stalk-like structure. I am drawing it here so that it becomes clear. This is known as anther, and this is connected to a stalk-like structure that is known as filament, F-I-L-A-M-E-N-T, and this whole structure collectively known as stamen or you can say androecium. This is male reproductive part. Now after that there is G and H. G is stigma, style, ovary. Inside ovary there is ovule. This stigma, style, ovary will known as carpel or gynoecium. It is also named as pistil. In some books, pistil is also written, so don't get confused. This is the female reproductive part. Next, inside ovary, there is lobule-like structure that is known as ovule. In next slide, we will study about the structure of the ovule, ovary, and then what is happening, what is pollination, and how the process is going to continue. See, what are the events that take place in reproduction in a bisexual flower? First of all, this diagram is already given in your NCERT book. Those students who are from other board, this is the basic diagram that is given in their book. This is pollen grains. This is stigma. Stigma is very much sticky in nature. Why it is sticky? Because simply it has to receive all the pollen grains. After that, this tube-like structure is style, and there is one swollen part that is known as ovary. Inside ovary, there is ovule. The first step is that pollen needs to be transferred from anther to stigma of a flower. This process is known as pollination. Pollination means the transfer of pollen grains from anther. This is known as stamen hole. This is anther and this is filament. In order to study this, let me open this whiteboard. Then it will become more clear. See, this is known as anther. Here now anther is looking like bipod, but it is having total four lobe. Two is backside, that is not visible. Okay, if you simply see like this, it will like this. This is filament. When anther will be struck by some external agents like air or water, it will get ruptured, and when it will rupture, there is secretion of some ball-like structure, small spores-like structure that is known as pollen grains. And now these pollen grain needs to be transferred from this anther to the stigma of a flower, and this process is known as pollination. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma or within a flower or to the flower that is present in the same plant, then that type of pollination will become self-pollination. If The flower that is doing pollination means anther is from another flower of the another plant, and the stigma is of the another flower that is present on the another plant. Then the pollination will become cross pollination. Always one question comes regarding pollination in long answer type. Then what is pollination? What are their types? Now next, after pollination, what will happen? The pollination, see, this is followed by agents like wind, water or animals. The pollination that is taking place by wind is known as anemophily. The pollination that is taking place by water is hydrophily. Yeah, I will tell you about triple fusion and double fertilization. Don't worry. That is the soul of the chapter. And students get confused in that. I will clear you out. Don't worry. If the pollination is getting taking place by animal, that is known as zoophily. One thing more I want to add is that if it is taking place by the help of insect, then it is known as entomophily. You know now the branch of science that deals with the study of insects known as entomology. I discussed in the class also the similarly entomo word is basically for insect. If it is taking place for the pollination, it will become entomophily. Next, now what happened once now the pollen grain has already reached this stigma. Now let us see the further story. What will happen? After the pollen lands on a suitable stigma, it has to reach the female germ cell. But female germ cell is there. Inside the ovary, inside the ovule, this pollen grain have to cross this passage. For this, a tube grows out of the pollen grain and through the stipe reach the ovary. Now let's discuss this. I will use a whiteboard. This is the structure of a pollen grain. Pollen grain is covered by two layers. The outermost layer is wing shaped and is known as axine. The innermost layer is circular and is known as intyme. It contains two nucleus. This is generative nucleus. Circular in shape, and the other one is tube nucleus. As it is clear by the name of the tube nucleus, you can guess that it will help in the formation of pollen tube. Now this pollen grain, when it will go on the stigma, suppose this is a stigma, it will come here, then what will happen? There will be rupture in this area. Let me rupture this area by the help of eraser. See, this gets ruptured like this. Now what will happen? There will be a simple longitudinal formation like structure. This is known as tube like structure. And these two nucleus will also be shifted. It will come like this. This is your generative nucleus and this is your tube nucleus. After some time, what will happen? It will become larger. And this generative nucleus will undergo mitotic division here. In this case, there will be one mitotic division. Only in this case, mitotic division means there will be multiplication. One nucleus will be converted into two nucleus. So there will be two nucleus, and this is known as sperm nuclei, or in some book it is written as male nuclei. This tube nucleus is now getting degenerated because it is helping in the formation of pollen tube. What will happen towards the stigma? Let us consider. Let me make some more neat and clean diagram. This is the pollen tube. This pollen tube is consisting of sperm nuclei. Here, this swollen portion is known as ovary. Inside ovary, there is ovule. Ovule contains three structure here, and then three cell structure here, and in between there is polar nuclei. Always remember that the polar nuclei is having two nucleus. So this is diploid in nature. This structure is, this is polar nuclei, egg cell and synergids. Egg cell, these two are synergids and these all are antipodals. So out of this structure, only this polar nuclei is going to do the fertilization process and this egg cell is going to do the process of fertilization. So in order to study how the fertilization process will take place, see. Now, how many male nuclei was there? Two. So one male nuclei is having chromosome number 1N and another is also having 1N. In this is the case of male. In case of female, there was one polar nuclei, but polar nuclei was containing two nucleus. So it becomes diploid. And there was one egg cell that I told you. And instead of these egg cell polar nuclei, the antipodals and synergids, they are simply for the support. They will not perform any function and after fertilization, they will get degenerate. So this egg cell is haploid in nature. So one of the male, let me write here sperm cells or sperm nuclei, not cells, so that you do not get confused. See, one of the male nuclei, sperm nuclei, will fuse with the 2N and one of the male nuclei will fuse with the N. This is male gamete. Male gamete 1N is getting fused with the female gamete, the egg cell N. Then what it will become? 2N. 2N is known as diploid, that is zygote. This is known as fertilization. Fertilization means the fusion of male and female gamete to form zygote. Now let us see the story of the second sperm nuclei. See, this is 1N, but it will combine with 2N. Everybody mute your mic please, I am getting disturbed. So 2N plus 1N, what it will become? 3N. 3N means it is triploid in nature. And the structure is known as, from where this sound is coming, can everybody listen? Hello? The 3N structure is known as endosperm. Endosperm is triploid in nature and it is a nutritive and nourishment giving tissue to the zygote. Now somebody was asking me about triple fusion. So this is triple fusion, this second step. The step in which one sperm nuclei will fuse with the polar nuclei of the male so that there is formation of triploid endosperm is known as triple fusion. And the first step in which simple there was there was reaction between or combination of one male gamete fused with another female gamete so that 2N is formed, that is zygote, that is simply known as fertilization. So how many times protein fertilization takes place? This is first step and this is also a kind of fertilization. What is the general meaning of fertilization? Fertilization means fusion of male gamete with female gamete. It does not decide about the chromosome number. So here is also fusion takes place, male gamete, female gamete. Here is also fusion takes place. So the fusion of male and female gamete is taking place two times, means fertilization is taking place two times in this process. That's why it is known as double fertilization. In first step there is simple fertilization, and in second step there is triple fusion. And this simple fertilization and triple fusion will combinedly form double fertilization. This is the whole story. Next, fertilization, I want to see the diagram is once again mentioned here. I explained to you this is pollen tube, a pollen grain. This layer is known as axine, and this layer is known as intyme. This is generating nucleus, this is tube nucleus. One male gamete plus egg cell will make zygote. This is the simple fertilization, that is known as first fertilization. Second fertilization, one gamete. Male gamete will fuse with two pollen nuclei that will form endosperm. Endosperm, what is? Always remember, endosperm will give continuous nutrition and nourishment to the developing embryo or to the developing zygote. This is known as triple fusion, because how many nuclei are getting fused? 2 plus 1, 3. And this is 1 plus 1, only 2. And these both steps combined, they will known as double fertilization. Can you listen to my voice, please, class? Once again, reply me in the chat box. Okay. Can you understood whatever is going in the class, or simply just sitting and listening? See, now fertilization is over. Story of fertilization is over. Now we will see that what will happen in post-fertilization. Post-fertilization is after fertilization. After fertilization, the petal will fall off, sepals will also fall off, the ovary. See, this part was ovary now. This was your stigmatized ovary, and inside ovary there was ovule. So this ovary will be converted into fruit, and this ovule will be converted into seed. This question is also sometimes coming in the exam, that please mention the post-fertilization event. Obviously, they will not say please, means mention the post-fertilization event. So simply you have to write that. First you will write petals and sepals will fall off, and ovary will be converted into fruit, and ovule will be converted into seed. Very easy. There's no problem, I think. Next. Now, after this, we will discuss about reproduction in human beings. Everybody know that reproduction that takes place in human being is sexual reproduction, because there is formation of male and female gamete. The male gamete is known as sperm, and the female gamete is known as ova. As we already discussed, that the male sperm, that is gamete, is motile, and the ova is non-motile. Why sperm is motile? Because it has a small tail-like structure. See, there is one term that is puberty. Puberty is that period of time in an individual when the person is going to attain sexual maturity. If we talk about sexual maturity means the person is growing certain organs, certain changes in their body that will help to find them that they are little bit getting mature for the process of reproduction, so in future they can do the process of reproduction. So puberty is that age, that period of time which will help the adolescent to get to know that they are getting sexually mature. Difference between puberty and adolescence is that adolescence is a age that is between 13 to 19. Adolescence means simple, they will tell you about the age factor, means 13 to 19 you will known as adolescence. Those who know Hindi, they can easily know that is known as Kishora Avastha. Okay, the age of your group, 13 to 19. But if we talk about some changes that is happening in this age group, means if we talk about sexual changes, not any changes, if we are studying this chapter, reproduction, so if we observe any sexual change in the adolescent age, that is known as Puberty. Understood? Someone, Shreyas, I think, was asking this question. Have you understood? If you understood, please say yes. See, adolescent is simply the age. And if you are, if we are talking about the sexual maturity in that age, that will be known as puberty. So here is one diagram. See, estrogen and testosterone. Very easy. Testosterone is released by testes. Testes is a male reproductive organ. The function of testes is, let me write it down here also when I am explaining it so that it becomes clear. See, testes is a male reproductive organ. For male, I am making this sign. And ovary is a female reproductive organ. So testes will do two functions. First, it will help in the formation of sperm. Second, it will release testosterone hormone that is given here. Now, by the help of testosterone hormone only, there are certain changes that are taking place in boys. That is, body hair grows. There will be development of hair on the different region of your body. Your voice will become heavy. It will break. It will look like a mature voice. Muscle will grow. Muscle growth increases. Obviously, your shoulders will become more dominant. And you can say mustache and beard will come on your face. Okay. Simply ovary will also do its two function. It will release ova for reproduction, and second, it will release the hormone that is known as progesterone and estrogen. Estrogen, due to estrogen, there will be some changes in the female body that will help to identify them that they are moving towards puberty. They are going to be mature for reproduction. The thing is, there will be development of breasts. Pubic hair growth means there will be development of hair in different parts of the body, like underarms, armpit, wide hips develop, and there is no change in the voice. Okay, so these are the important thing. And one more thing I want to tell you, student, that these changes that are coming due to estrogen in female and testosterone in male, they are also known as secondary sexual characteristic. In books it's written, and sometimes most of them become confused that, ma'am, what is primary sexual characteristic and what is secondary sexual characteristics. See, in secondary sexual characteristic, you will have these changes in your body. And what will is primary sexual characteristic? In primary, the male will release sperm and the female will release ova. So this, the release of sperm and ova is primary, and development or changes in the body that takes place during puberty is secondary. Is it clear? I hope it's become clear. Okay. So let us move towards another slide. Male reproductive system, female reproductive system. Out of these male and female, pakka surely one will come in exam. They will ask you to make the diagram, or simply they will make the diagram and you have to label the parts and tell about the function. Here is the diagram. Okay. First of all, let us study what is male reproductive system. If it is a system, it means it is a collection of certain organs or certain things. As you already studied about digestive system, then respiratory system. Every system contains some organs or some parts. Similarly, male reproductive system will also consist the portion, means it will contain some parts that will help in the formation of the germ cells. Now you will ask that, what is germ cells? So germ cells is nothing, they are simply the sperm. Okay, the cells that will help in the process of reproduction. Okay, I will clear the doubt. Please collect your doubt, and at last I will clear everybody's doubt. Okay, so first is, what is the male reproductive system? Tell me doubt, please write. David, can you listen to me? In a vessel, I don't know why simply you ask those questions which I am going to explain you in the next slide. See, I will tell you about tubectomy and vasectomy. don't get mean so impatient. When we will study about reproductive health, then we will study about this vasectomy and then vas deferens and what these all things. Okay, first let us study about the structure and then we will study about the reproductive health. I will clear all your doubts, don't worry. See, male reproductive system contains a pair of testes. Testes will be in pair. If you want to see the diagram, so that it will become more easy to learn. This pink shaped structure, wait, let me choose this marker. See, this pink shaped structure, one, and here is one more, that is two. This is known as a pair of testes. Next part is mentioned. Second is ducts. Ducts can be of three types: epididymis, vas deferens or the sperm ducts, and the third is urethra. See, urethra is simply a common that will found in the urine system also. Third is glands. There are different types of glands that will secrete some secretion that will help in the motility of the sperm. Glands will release some secretion that will help the sperm to move. Next is a copulatory organ that is called penis. By the help of penis only all the sperm will come outside of the reproductive organ. Okay, so one by one we will study about the function. See, testes, as I told you in the previous slide also, testes function is to produce male gamete, that is sperms, and the second is it will release a hormone, that is testosterone. Next, attached to each testes is a highly coiled tube-like structure that is known as epididymis. This tube-like structure is known as epididymis, this over the testes. The main function of epididymis is that it will give protection to the cushion-shaped testes. They will help in the temperature. See, whatever doubt is, do you all have kids? I will mention, I will clear it at the end. First, let us study the structure and function. This, let us first complete this structure, then I will clear your doubt. Because if I will clear your doubt without telling you the structure and function, it doesn't make any sense. This epididymis, their function is that they will give proper temperature to these testes so that the sperm that is present inside the testes does not get inactivated. Okay, this is the main function. Next, vas deferens. Vas deferens, you know, that is passage for sperms in the male body. This you can say vas deferens, this is a tube-like structure, means this is testes, testes is releasing sperm, the sperm will come out from here, it is a kind of passage by the help of vas deferens, it will come here in the urethra. Urethra is common for the release of sperm as well as common for the release of urine. It is written here also, it is the common passage for both semen and urine. Now what is semen? Semen is a, you can say it is a fluid that contains sperm and some chemicals. The chemicals are present in semen along with the sperm that will allow the sperms to motile, to make it more, you can say that it will help in the maximum movement of the sperm. So the combination of sperm and the chemical is known as semen. Next is penis. This part, it is given in the diagram, this is known as penis. Penis is the only organ by which all the sperm that is coming from the testes here to here, it will come outside of the body and it can enter inside the female body for the process of reproduction. Here one word is mentioned, that it is always supplied with blood vessels. Every living part is supplied with continuous blood vessels because the blood will act as a medium that will give the continuous hormones, enzymes, oxygen, and then proteins, all the things to these sperms, so that the sperms can generate more and more, because sperm is also kind of cell and that are living. And similarly, We can also see the female reproductive system. In female reproductive system is few things are similar. For example, in male there was a pair of testes, and in female there is a pair of ovary. Can you see this small structure, means rounded structure? This rounded, see, first point is here it is written fallopian tube. Fallopian, about fallopian tube. See, this fallopian tube is a tube like structure, but at the end of this fallopian tube there is some finger like structure, this. So this is known as fimbriae. Please see the diagram carefully, learn how I am labeling the diagram, that is most important. See how to make the arrows, it should be neat and clean, because in exam the diagram contains maximum marks. So you can score well in exam by the help of diagram also, and the labeling should also be correct. Please focus on that. That is coming, that is very important.
Ma'am, Stuti wanted you to repeat the temperature regulation in the male reproductive system.
I will repeat you in the last, okay? Let us study first female reproductive system. There is nothing like temperature regulation. This is very simple. It will, the sperm needs some degree of temperature, that I will, somebody has asked me also that what is the, this way I will discuss in the later, but first complete this, let us complete this, because if we have done male, similarly female is also somewhat similar to it, so don't break it. I will tell you all the answers, don't panic. Next, this is finger like structure is known as fimbriae, okay? But the fimbriae is attached to the ovary. This ovary, what is the function of ovary? There is one pair of ovary. Always remember, inside one ovary there will be formation of ova, and in next month, in the next ovary there will be formation of another ova. In females there are two ovary, one by one there will be formation of ova. The formation of ova takes place in the immature baby also, that is baby girl, but it will not, is she is not able to do reproduction, that's why it's, they become deactivated. Next is cervix. Cervix, we can see third part, this part is known as cervix, lower to the uterus. Fourth is uterus, this part where there is implantation, means there will be this ova will come out in the fallopian tube. If there is a sperm coming inside vagina, this fifth part is known as vagina. This is a canal like structure, that is birth canal. If a sperm is coming inside and the sperm is coming here, and from here, see, sperm I am making like this, motile. The ova is also coming here. They will fuse with each other. Fertilization will take place, and that is known as zygote. Now this zygote will come inside the uterus and it will get attached to the wall of the uterus. That is, the wall of the uterus is known as endometrium. And the process by which the zygote will get attached to the wall of uterus, or the process in which the zygotes get attached to the endometrium, is known as implantation. This question last year, not last year, in 2017 it came for ICSC, and in CBSE also it comes, that what is implantation. So remember this, that the process of attachment of zygote towards the, to the endometrium or to the uterine wall is known as implantation. This is the structure, simple structure of the female reproductive system. Everything is mentioned in the slide. If you, the class gets over, please try to make the diagram and practice it.
Implantation again.
What?
Ma'am, can you define implantation again?
See, implantation, I don't, whose mic is on? Still some voice is coming. Please get a switch off your, means mute your mic. Implantation is the process. Should I write it down? You want to copy it? Let me see, I have mentioned in the slide or not. Implantation is the process in which the zygote attached to the uterine wall or endometrium. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Now next, let us study each and every function. In order to understand about the function, once again I have copied this diagram here. See, first fallopian tube. You know this is fallopian tube? It's so easy. See, tube-like structure, fallopian tube. There are two fallopian tubes. This is one and this is two. Means each of the fallopian tube is attached to each of the ovary. The end line close to the ovary has finger-like structure. I told you this finger-like structure is somewhat looking like a villi. You, if you remember in the excretory system, but it's not villi, it's fimbriae. The two fallopian tubes unites to form an elastic tube-like structure called uterus. See, this fallopian tube will come here, this will come here, and then it will form uterus. Okay, in Hindi it is known as bachchedani. If those who knows Hindi, they can also understand. Those who do not know, that is also fine, that it's simply known as uterus. Function, what is the function? It is tube-like, obviously it is going to provide passage. Site of fertilization of male and female gamete, means the sperm will be here, the ovary is releasing ova, that will also come by the help of fallopian tube, and here will be the fertilization process. Transport the egg from the ovary to the uterus. Now this egg, ova is coming here, it is getting fertilized, and then from here the zygote will come in the uterus by the help of this fallopian tube. And when it will come in the uterus and attach to the endometrium or to the uterine wall, it will known as, what it will known? Tell me class, please write down in chat box. At least try to answer my question also. I am answering your question. I know that I am not seeing so many questions, whatever you are asking. But simply, I am whatever I am seeing, I am asking. No, not vagina, beta. This is vagina. What is this? This is the uterus. Okay, good. Mute your mic, please. Whose mic is on? Next. Next is ovary. The ovary is an organ found in the female reproductive system that produces ova. Ovum and ova both are same. The ovary function is that it will release ova as well as it will release two hormones, that is estrogen and progesterone. Now a question can arise in your mind that I already told you about estrogen, that estrogen is responsible for making secondary sexual characteristic, that is the development of breast, menstrual cycle will come, and development of hair in different parts of the body. Then when progesterone is released, so always remember progesterone is released during the time of pregnancy in female. This hormone is released at the time of pregnancy. Next, cervix, third part. This is the point, the narrow-like structure, the narrow end of the uterus is known as cervix. It's very simple. Uterus, uterus is a hollow muscular organ. It is somewhat, you can say, this is V-shaped structure. In female pelvis, that is between the bladder and the rectum. In simple language, if the question comes in exam, what is uterus? The uterus is a hollow muscular organ where the implantation process takes place. Implantation is the key word. Always remember, implantation means attachment of the zygote, means embryo that is getting formed. Zygote will convert into embryo. Everybody know embryogenesis will take place. And then it will attach at the wall of the uterus, that is known as implantation. So this will be the definition for the uterus. Next is function, the same thing. The embryo formed in the fallopian tubes comes down and get attached to the endometrium. See, somebody was asking, you know, the definition of implantation, it's mentioned here. Implantation and develops for the next 9 months till the baby is delivered. Okay, it means in the uterus, the fetus development will take place. Fifth is vagina. Vagina is similar to penis as it was in male reproductive system. Simply, the outer part of the female reproductive system, vagina, that opens through the cervix. Means after cervix, if any part is coming, this is cervix and this is your vagina. Next. Now, placenta. One important term comes, placenta. Placenta is a connection between the mother and the fetus. Now, what is fetus? The child that is present in the mother womb. We will not call it child or kid. We will simply say it fetus. The fetus is getting attached to the mother body, means the connection between the maternal tissue and the fetus known as placenta. By the help of this placenta only, there will be continuous nutrition as well as nourishment given to the fetus. Why? Because this placenta is containing blood. If you want to know the structure, suppose if this is the structure of fetus, this is the whole mother womb. Okay, so here will be a tube-like structure like this. This is known as placenta. This placenta is attached to the maternal tissue. Maternal tissue means mother body tissue. And in between the fetus, there will be circulation of blood from mother to fetus. This blood will bring oxygen, nutrition, enzymes, hormones, proteins, vitamins, everything for the fetus. And the fetus will take oxygen and it will release carbon dioxide and it will also release some waste material. And these waste material as well as this respiratory waste gas that will move from the fetus towards the mother body for for expiration by the help of this placenta. So whenever the kid is the fetus is in the mother womb, it drink the mother milk. Simply you can understand by this way also, that will be more easy, because by the help of blood only it will get total nutrition as well as nourishment. Next, arteries and veins are present in the placenta, but they are very fine. They are not much clearly visible. They are not fully developed also, because it's for 9 months only. Next is menstruation. Menstruation in some book is written as menstrual cycle. Menstrual cycle is a cycle that every female get after every 28 days. The menstrual cycle is simply the unfertilized ovum. Now, what is the meaning of unfertilized? Fertilized ovum means when the ovum gets combined with the sperm, then it will form zygote. If the ovum is not getting the sperm, then in that case, that ovum becomes unfertilized. And every month, every female is releasing one ovum. So every time, if they are not getting the sperm, obviously, then that will remain unfertilized. And in that case, this unfertilized ovum get rupture, that get degenerate, and it comes out of the vagina in the form of blood, that is known as menstrual cycle. The duration is normal of 28 days. When this menstrual cycle begins, that is known as menarche, that is of the age 14 to 15 is the normal age, but nowadays it has been, the survey has been done and it has been found that it has started in females and girls at the age of 12 also. Stoppage of menstruation means when the menstrual cycle gets over, it will not come again and again. That means it will get pause. That is menopause. And it is clear by the name. See, you can understand pause. Pause means stop. That is known as the menstrual cycle is getting stopped. That is known as menopause. So menstrual cycle is one of the secondary sexual characteristics. If there the menstrual cycle is getting stopped, if the female is getting menopause, means now she can't do the process of fertilization and she can't be pregnant. The age is 45 to 50 years. But previously it was only 50 years. But as I told you, in case of menarche is getting at the age of 12 and 30 now, nowadays. Similarly, menopause is also getting at the age of 45. Understood? Do the polar bodies come with the menstrual discharge or pre-menstrual discharge? Which polar bodies? Please clarify which type of polar bodies. Polar bodies we studied in flower, if you remember. That was the structure of ovule. Next, reproductive path. See, if there is primary oocyte, yeah, everything will come out because the simply the ovum is coming out, so everything that is going to be the part of reproduction will come out in the form of menstrual cycle. Menstrual cycle is the healthy sign of the healthy reproductive structure. Now, after studying different structure and function, we should also know about the health that is related to it, reproductive health. It's very important to know that your reproductive organs are healthy or not, if there is any problem, so that you can consult the doctor, and you should be aware. That's why this chapter is in your syllabus, because you are good enough to know about these things, you should be aware. See, sexually transmitted disease. Sexually transmitted disease means the disease that are transferred by the process of intercourse. It can be bacterial as well as it can be viral also. Bacterial infection causes gonorrhea and syphilis. These are the two basic and the most common diseases nowadays. And viral diseases, HIV, AIDS and VARS. This question comes in short answer. Remember, name two sexually transmitted bacterial disease, gonorrhea and syphilis. Name two sexually transmitted viral disease, that is VARS and HIV AIDS. Now, in order to get rid of these disease, or you have listened the word prevention is better than cure, what are the process, what are the methods by which one can be get rid of this sexually transmitted disease? First, there are so many methods. See, first is use of condoms prevent these infections to some extent, contraception. See, these two points simply I write down here because the question comes in exam, they will ask that give any two methods. If the question is coming, give any two methods, simply that is 2 marks question. So simply you can write these 2 points, okay? And if the question is coming in long answer type, then you can write this method. Physical, chemical, let me show you. Physical, chemical, IUCD and surgical method. This whole portion will come in 5 marks question, and it's very important for you to remember. Let us study one by one. First method of contraception is physical barrier. Physical barrier means something that will not allow the union of the sperm and the egg. It can be condoms, cervical caps and diaphragm. Condoms are used by males, cervical caps and diaphragm are used by female. Next is chemical method. Chemical method is simply by taking medicine, or you can say chemical pills, oral pills. Some names are also mentioned in few books like Maladi and Saheli. These all are chemical methods, oral pills, by the help of which there are some hormone will release inside your body. There will be some disbalance in the hormone and the body of the female will not release the eggs. When there will be no eggs, then there is no chances of fertilization. But this method has so many side effects, and that is good for the health of your uterus also. Next method is IUCD, intrauterine contraceptive device. Some device has been inserted by the cesareans and doctors and gynecologists so that the sperm, if it is coming inside the vagina or uterus of the female, it will not fuse with the ova. Best example is copper T. The structure is somewhat like this. Copper T like structure is inserted, and this is one of the IUCD, intrauterine contraceptive devices. Yeah, cancer can be side effect also, because if there is any injury, even in IUCD, if there is any kind of injury inside the uterus and if it does not get heal up, it will produce cancer. And the second is that if the eggs are not getting released by the help of these oral pills, and the day when person is stop using this oral pills, there are chances that still the eggs does not get released, because if we will disturb our hormones, there will be certain side effects. Everybody knows that if we will play with our hormones, or if there is certain drastic changes in the body regarding hormone, there are some side effects. Next is surgical method. Surgical method means related to surgery. What you will do? Simply the one somebody was asking, now, ma'am, what is vasectomy? What is tubectomy? Now, here is the answer. See, vas deferens was the part of male reproductive organ. Fallopian tubule was the part of female reproductive organ. When vas deferens are cut and tie up, means there is blocked. Sorry, some blockage is produced. Then the process is known as vasectomy. Similarly, if the fallopian tube is cut and it's tied up and it is getting blocked, so what will happen? From ovary, who is this? Suppose if fallopian tube is blocked, then the ovary that is releasing ova, it can't come. Please don't open your video. Class is getting disturbed. So fallopian tube, if it is cut down, the ovary that is releasing ovum, it will not get the passage to transfer and it will remain in the ovary only. And similarly, if vas deferens is blocked, then the testes that are releasing sperm, they will also not get any passage. And when they will not get any passage, then they will not going to move. So simply they will remain at the same place. So the process is known as vasectomy and tubectomy. This is a permanent method for avoiding the pregnancies as well as breast contraception, so that there is no any chances of reproductive problem.
Ma'am? Ma'am, so like, do the sperms like live or do they like die and they're like given out through urine or something?
No. Simply what will happen, the sperm that are getting produced, when they will not get the way, simply they will become inactivated. See, the sperm is having a small tail. If you remember the diagram, trying to swim, but if they will not get the passage, due to extra pressure and extra heat, they will be inactivated and then there will be less secretion of sperm. Understood? This is the entire process. See, now we have completed this. Somebody has made a smiley also. Now we are going to discuss about the questions, that how the questions are coming in board and how you have to write. No, one point is left. That is female porticide. See, everybody know female porticide. Female porticide means some the fetus is killed inside the mother wombs only. Parents used to go and get to know about the sex of the child, that she is male or female. If she is female, then they used to do the porticide. That is mostly observed in the case of Haryana. And if this thing carries out, there will be certain disturbance in the sex ratio in the society. And obviously, there will be the larger number of male and lesser number of females, and then there will be problem, because for a balanced environment, for a balanced surrounding, there should be balanced number of male and female. Okay, and this is illegal also. Prenatal sex determination is illegal. Now we will move towards previous year questions. Who is saying why? Obviously, it is illegal. Now next. Previous year questions. First is, few questions that are short answer, I will tell you how to write here only, and those who are large, I will make you the diagram. The things which I explained to you in the PPT, only those type only, that is the see I have made you how to write fertilization, what is implantation, that only question comes, that these are those questions that are going to repeat again and again, because the whole syllabus contains this much only. Nothing is going to come outside of this, so don't worry in exam. First is, name two plants that are grown by vegetative propagation. Now everybody please write your answer in your chat box. Stop doing discussion. Oh, who is saying bryophyta? No. I have told you now, vegetative propagation takes place in those plants which are seedless. Simply you have to write answer like this. First is banana, someone is telling wood, and second is simple, your favorite flower, most of your students, rose. Okay, this will be the answer for question number one. Second, what is reproduction? Explain two advantages of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction. I was screaming when I was telling this. Who will tell me in one word? See, first you have to write here. Always make sure that your writing should be neat and clean so that the examiner can understand what you are writing. Reproduction is a process by which living organisms. Always write the answer in two to three lines. For example, if it has been asked that what is reproduction, 2 to 3 lines are sufficient to write the answers. You don't have to create the stories. Are to produce young ones. Instead of young ones, you can also use offsprings. Of their kind. Now the second part of the question is asking, explain 2 advantages of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction. So how you will explain? Advantages, first you will write the small heading, advantages of sexual reproduction. I think you can continue this from the question only. Advantages of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction. Okay, this you can write. Now how many points you have to mention? 2 points. So only mention 2 points and always remember the point that is important. Try to write it at the first only. So first is variation. The variations are observed because you have to explain also that why variation is observed, because it involves fusion of male. Now in exam don't use symbol as I was using in explaining you the PPT. Please don't use symbol. It involves fusion of male and female gamete. Second advantage is that offspring produced are genetically and morphologically not similar. Means there will be some changes. See, I will tell you one more point so that if you in exam you skip one of the point or you forget one point, so you have one more point so that you can add and make 2 points. Always takes place in slow manner. Understood? This way you have to write answer. Next, list any 2 differences between pollination and fertilization. Pollination and fertilization. Pollination, in you write simply the transfer of pollen grains. Let me write this answer because if I will say, you will not get clear. The question is, what is the difference between pollination and fertilization. Simply, first of all, you will put one heading, pollination. Now you will start writing the transfer of, make proper space between two words. Pollen and grain should be separated. Some students write collectively. These are two different words. The transfer of pollen and grains from anther to stigma of a flower is known as pollination. See, if the, now there is no need of simply telling about the types. If you are adding it, it's okay. If you are not adding it, then also your marks is not going to be deducted because the question is about pollination. Next, about fertilization, once again you should make one heading. Fertilization, the fusion of, here also you will not use the symbol female, the fusion of male and female gametes to produce, instead of produce, you can also write the word form, a zygote, is called fertilization. Okay? Always, if the question is asked in terms of differences, simply you have to make one heading, describe that part. Only that much that is required, and then you have to tell about the fertilization. Next, name any two sexually transmitted diseases caused due to viral infection. Everybody please write in the chat box now this answer. Sexually transmitted disease, viral infection, HIV, and one more, bots, very good. In AIDS, AIDS and WARS. Always remember, in AIDS you have to write everything. AIDS should be capital and comma WARTS, WARS. This is 2 marks question. It came in 2008. Now explain the terms implantation, placenta. What is the average duration of human pregnancy? Most of the time everybody write 9 months, but that is not correct. Simply you have to write 280 days. Okay, remember this, keep it in your mind, exact average pregnancy is 280 days. Next, implantation. I told you the process of attachment of the zygote to the intrauterine wall or to the endometrium is known as implantation. Next is placenta. Placenta is the connection between the maternal tissue and the baby. Placenta is responsible for giving nutrition and nourishment to the developing fetus. Understood? Say yes or no. Reply in the chat box. Okay. Now, why is DNA copying is an essential part of the process reproduction? DNA copy is an essential part of the process of reproduction because when the DNA gets replicated, it forms another DNA that is needed to be incorporated into the cells. Next is, list any 4 methods of contraception used by humans. What are the 4 methods discussed in the previous slide also? How does their use have a direct effect on the health and prosperity of a family? See, this part of the question is already mentioned here. In 4 points, you will write this physical barrier. Then this is chemical methods, intrauterine contraceptive device, and this is surgical method. This four you have to write. If the question is in long answer type, then you will write the entire thing. If it is coming simply name the method, then only you will write this heading, like physical barrier, chemical methods, intrauterine contraceptive device, and surgical method. Understood? No need of writing this last point, female 40 side. Next, define the terms pollination and fertilization. See, it's not now. Can you see? I have done little bit zoom. Wait, is it clear? Define the term pollination and fertilization. Now, can you write down this question? Obviously, I explained to you in the previous. Draw a diagram of pistil showing pollen tube growth into the ovule and label them. Now, see, this is diagram based question. How you will do? You have to make the diagram of pistil. Pistil means carpel. Carpel means gynoecium. There are three cell structure here and there are three cell structure here. This is known as stigma. Make that arrow properly in the board copies so that there is no confusion. Style, ovary. This is ovule. Now this ovule contains this center is known as egg cell. These two are known as synergids. And these three are known as antipodals. There is one more cell in between which contains two nuclei. This cell is known as central cell. There is marking on the labeling also. Simply you don't have to make the diagram and come label it properly. These two are known as polar nuclei. Let me once again see the question. Pollen tube growth into the ovule. Okay. This is your pollen tube. Simply this is coming like this. My pen is a little bit thick. It's not getting thin, but yeah, like this. And then this will come slowly, slowly here, and then it will come here. Yeah, it will go near the excel. This is the diagram that you have to make if the question will come in exam. Next, describe in brief the role of testes. Testes help in the formation of sperm, and they will help in the release of hormone testosterone. Seminal cycle will release chemicals that in the motility of the sperm. Vas deferens will give the passage for the movement of the sperm from the testes to the urethra. Prostate gland will release some hormones and secretion that will also increase the motility of the sperm. Question number 7 I will answer in the last first let us discuss, because once I have discussed it, you will get the required form of this lecture. Draw a diagram of the longitudinal section of a flower and label its sepal, petal, ovary and stigma. Write the name of male and female reproductive. Okay. See, first is also diagram based question. Let us do this. How you will make the flower? It's very easy. See. Let us change the color first of all. These all are sepals. These are petals. In order to make this is stamen. This is your anther and this is your filament. When you will label in exam, always mention that anther and filament is the stamen. They can also be known as androecium, and they can also be known as androecium. Let me complete this. Now this is stigma. This is style. And this part is ovary. This stigma, I'm making a star, stigma, style and ovary. So here you can write in this way also. If you do not have, you have the rough diagram, you don't have to make it dirty. So stigma, style and ovary is known as pistil, carpel as well as gynoecium. See, you don't have to write all these three. It means if out of these three, if any one of you will write, it is correct. If you want to write in a collected manner, then you can write this way also, that this is known as pistil, carpel or gynoecium. This is your petal, sepals, and this is the base of the flower, that is known as stalk. And here is a swollen womb, that is known as thalamus. But if you ignore thalamus and stalk, that will be okay, but you don't have to ignore these parts. Always remember. Who has done this? Name the process by which amoeba reproduce. You know amoeba reproduction. I told you when I was explaining you about the binary fission. Name various stages of its reproduction in a proper sequence. You have to draw the diagram of binary fission. Who has made these boxes on the screen? Please clear this. How it has done? Who has done this on the screen? Nothing is clear to anybody. See, these are the questions which are mentioned in the slide. Last year questions. Can you see the screen? Please type in the chat box. Yeah, now it is over. See, now we have discussed these questions and diagrams, how you have to make. Previous year questions, question number one, the same thing. Then question number two, these are the questions along with answers I have mentioned in the slide, so that you should know that how you have to write the answers along with year. Here everything is visible. Who can't see anything? Now is it visible? Okay. These are the questions of 2017. Long as well as short, you can see these questions. Now this is the model paper of last year. I would like to share with you that how the students have written the answer. See, sexual mode of reproduction is uniparental, means it involves only one parent, does not involve any fusion of gamete, hence fertilization means that when there is no gamete, there is no chance of fertilization. Sexual mode of reproduction is biparental. Biparental means it will involve fusion of both male and female gametes. Among the two, sexually reproductive species is a better chances of survival. Why? Because they have the better chances of variation. This to be reproduction in such species require contrasting equal genetic material form both the way. See, multiple fission is not asked in board. If it will be asked, then you can write because I have explained that also. But most of the time, binary fission is asked. Now, the next question is, name the process by which an amoeba reproduces. This is binary. See, the child has written first stage karyokinesis and this the second step cytokinesis. Well, this is the model answer, but what I explained to you, if you will write that also, that is in little detail, I explained to the diagram of the region, that is more correct. If you write this much also, that is also correct. What I want to show you by the help of the model paper, okay? Next is, write the function of the following parts in female reproductive system. Oviduct, fallopian tube, uterus. See, these are the model answers. I have already mentioned in the slide in this PPT. So that whenever you see this PPT, you know that yes, you can see how you have to answer. See, all the answers are in point. Nothing is paragraph-like. You don't have to write the answers in paragraph. I am saying it 2 to 3 times that children, you have to write the answers in point because points are clearly visible by the examiner. And it is only the correct method of writing. Still, we have 10 to 15 minutes. We can discuss your problem. There is no need to get impatient. Now, these all are the assignment questions. After studying this chapter, I hope you are mature enough. You are means I think you can understand this question and try to solve this. Now, please, I will write here. Let me delete. Now, please come on chat box and one by one ask the question that you have the doubts. We have 10 minutes. The cysts are always formed in case there are bad conditions. Not bad conditions, the condition is unfavorable. Bad is not a correct word. Unfavorable means that there is too much heat, there is too much cold, there is disturbed in the pH level, the temperature is either getting very high or getting very low. pH is getting not proper. Ma'am, how are twins and triplets born? So twins and triplets are born there is fusion of more than 2 sperm with the same ova. See, sperm are produced in millions and trillions in male reproductive organs. But in case of female reproductive organs, in each ova there is only one egg. So when 2 sperm will fuse with one ova, then there is the formation of twins. Similarly, if 3 will fuse one ova, there will be triplets. Next question. Vaibhav was asking this question. Okay. Next, anybody? Ma'am, won't that form triploid? Yeah, obviously there will be some differences, and you have also observed that some twins are not able to survive also, those whose head and other body parts are joined. This is good question. Difference between fission and fragmentation. The difference between fission and fragmentation is very simple. In fission, there are 2 steps. How can you forget? Karyokinesis and cytokinesis. But in fragmentation, there is nothing like that. Simply, there will be small fragments and each fragment will develop into an adult. Clear, Madhumita? Triplet is due to unnatural circumstances. Yeah, you can say. But that is very detailed topic. It can't be explained in 10 minutes. Ma'am, would people who have had vasectomies have ejaculatory dreams? I think this question is not related to the topic. For this, I have to study. What are synergids? Very good. See, synergids and antipodals are that cell that does not have any specific function. Simply, they will give support to the other cells that are present in the ovule. If you want to know the answer, this is the answer. The synergids and antipodals are those cells which will give extra support to the egg cell and the central cell. Anybody else who is having problem? Why do transgender people have female body structure instead of male body structure? Due to the hormonal disbalance. See, if in male body there will be release of estrogen and progesterone hormone, so obviously there will be some secondary sexual characteristic development in the male body, and that's why they look like female. Have you listened to the name of Michael Jackson? He also tried to gender. He wants to become female. He injected so many hormones. If you want to know about that, please go on Quora and read about this. You will get to know many more things. Question number 7 of the paper. Question number 7, I don't need to see now. That was the same question, that why is DNA copying necessary? So DNA copying is necessary because during the time of cell division, there are formation of so many cells. But at the same time, the original cell contains DNA that is needed to be replicated. Replicated means it gets multiplied. And after multiplication and multiplication and multiplication, I am simply telling you in this way so that you understand, there are so many copies of DNA. And each of the DNA copy needed to be inserted in the newly formed cells. Because without DNA, if the cell is getting formed, that is not going to work. Can a polar body be fertilized? Polar body contains two nuclei, polar nuclei. They can't be fertilized with each other. Always remember, male gamete can fertilize with female and female with male. No two male gametes can fertilize with each other, and no female two gametes are going to fertilize with each other. Understood? A polar body is a small haploid cell that is formed as an egg cell during eugenesis, but which generally does not. Good answer. Polar bodies of primary oocyte, no, they do not fertilize it. Fertilization always takes place in opposite gametes. I hope that you understood. This lecture will be very much useful for you. If you want a quick revision, you can go on this. This PPT is the summary of this chapter. Whatever I have included in this PPT, that is the important things according to board point of view and according to the 10th syllabus. So it will be helpful for you. Have you understood how to write in exam? How to write the answers? How to make the diagrams? Labeling is necessary. You simply don't have to just make the diagram and keep it for the teacher. Any other question? Because in between somebody was saying that we have so many doubts. There was a time problem. So you can ask me. Still we have time. 5 to 10 minutes we have. 10 to 15. How does the erectile tissue maintain the volume of blood during copulation? See, the volume of blood during copulation is maintained by the hormonal coordination and nervous coordination. Can transgender people reproduce? In exceptional cases only. Still research is going on. Still scientists are working. Any question, children? How does scientists working on this now. I will tell how the scientists are simply taking totipotent cells. Totipotent cells are those cells which have the capacity to do the reproduction and the basic metabolic activities. So from the transgender, few cells have been taken, and that cells needed to be have culture media growth in the laboratory, and then there is some pH value checking, and then some chemicals are injected over it to see the result, and then to have a look that is there any possibility that it can be done. And this thing only would be understood by you when you will become little mature, because there are totipotent cells, stem cells, there are so many new terms that you don't even know. Very good, you should make Centum proud. I hope this revision class will be very useful for you, and I wish each and every of you who are watching this and attending the class, and those who are not watching and will watch later, that all the best, very best for you for your exam. And I think this chapter that is containing 8 marks is not going to lose by you, because everything that is going to come, I explained you in the class. All the very best. Okay. Thank you for joining me. Thank you, class.